Happy Sunday, everyone.
What a joy it is to be alive. What an even greater joy it is to be saved. I want to welcome you this morning to our morning of worship here at the Friendship Missionary Baptist Church of Hamilton, Georgia. Here, where we seek to glorify God through the love of Jesus Christ, anchored in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Also here at Friendship Baptist Church, we know that in the presence of the Lord, there is liberty. So feel free to dance and sing, free to lift your hands in worship, because the Son has set us free indeed.
So listen, here's your opportunity to participate in our worship right where you are.
So please join our services already in progress.
Lord, I'm free.
Yes, I am.
Lord, I'm free.
Hallelujah.
Lord, chapter 27, beginning at verse 5. I would that you stand all over the building as we seek to give context to this text in the second installment in or series of sermons concerning these stones. Deuteronomy chapter number 27, beginning, if you please, at verse number 5. When you find these words recorded, would you register by saying amen? The word of our God says, and there shalt thou build an altar unto the Lord thy God, an altar of stone. Thou shalt not lift up any iron tool upon them. Thou shalt build the altar of the Lord thy God of whole stones, and thou shalt offer burnt offerings thereon unto the Lord thy God. And thou shalt offer peace offerings, and shalt eat there, and rejoice before the Lord thy God. And verse 8 says, and thou shalt write upon the stones all the words of this law very plainly. With the Lord's help and your amens, do me a favor, turn to your neighbor next to you, say, neighbor, pastor's gonna preach about when stones come alive. Turn to the neighbor opposite of you, say to that neighbor, say, neighbor, pastor's gonna preach about when stones come alive. My brothers and sisters, we're thankful again for the writing of this text. I'm grateful today that God has again allowed Moses again to put pen to parchment, that we might ration and reason with the people of God to know the fact that our obligation in this life is to worship the Almighty God. I'm grateful this morning because there are those of you who come for no other reason, which is to worship the Almighty God. But that's why the Bible says, and I, if I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw all men unto me. Is that in vain today that we worship God? We worship him again in spirit and in truth. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, when I think about the goodness of God and all he has done for me, I cannot help but to tell the Lord, thank you. I thank God not simply because of the house he provides. I thank God not simply because of the car he provides. I thank God not because of the job he provides. I thank God not because of the family he provides. While all those things are good enough for us just to tell the Lord thank you, beyond those material things, I tell the Lord thank you that I have been born again. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, when you come to the point that you know who God is, and when you come to the point you understand the abilities that God has provided, you can't help but to worship God for who God really is. That's why when we talked about this text last week, we talked about being able to remember never to forget your stone. Why? Because you remember the children of Israel in context were coming across of Jordan into the land of Canaan. And God says to the children of Israel, if you're going to worship me, you got to first build an altar. Are y'all in here with me? The building of the altar, it symbolized a couple of things. First of all, it symbolized their place of worship. It would be there in the land of Canaan that these same Israelites would come to the point now where they would give the name of our God glory. No, reality, you can't give the name God glory because the name God is glory, but the reality is what you do in the giving of the name glory is acknowledge that there is no other glory like the glory of God's name. It was the place of worship there at the bigger building of the altar, but not only was it the place of worship, it was the permanency of their witness. It would be there in Canaan, the land of promise, the land of promotion, the land of prosperity. It would be in the land of Canaan that their witness would now become permanent, that anybody that came in and out of the land of Canaan would recognize that these stones were built to worship the Almighty God. And that's why I stopped by on my way to heaven's table to tell somebody, you ought to be able to build a worship altar that you can give the name of God some glory. You ought to be able to build an altar that you can worship God, not just when everything is going good, not just when everything is in order, not just when everything is on top of the ground, but is there anybody in here know that you ought to be able to worship God when you are going through your storm and your rain? I don't know who you are. I don't know where you're sitting, but not only is it a place of worship, but my witness ought to become permanent. All right. Are y'all in here with me? Not just a witness that says everything is going to be all right, but I need a witness to tell somebody that the wages of sin is still death, but the gift of God is still eternal life. I need a witness today that will cover my worship, because y'all do know God is still good to us. Anybody in here know God is still good to us? You do know God did not have to do what he does for us, but there ought to be somebody in here that's willing to tell the Lord, Lord, I just want to thank you. Is there six of y'all in here? I make seven that don't mind saying, Lord, I thank God you've been good to me, so I don't want to forget my stone. I want to build an altar. It was a place of worship. It was the permanency of my witness. But then lastly, you saw the place of God's will. He didn't tell them to build it in no other place, but he told them to build it in the place of Canaan. Why? Because I told you Canaan was a place of promise, a place of promotion, a place of prosperity. It was the place where God had blessed. Can I suggest to somebody in the building today that if you ever want the Lord to do some things for you that you can't do for yourself, I pray to get to the place where he blesses. If you ever want the Lord to walk around in your life, if you ever want the Lord to see your family through, I pray to get to the place where God blesses. Are y'all in here with me? Don't hang up on me. Click back over. I know he can bless you at home. I know he can bless you on your job. I know he can bless you wherever you are. But can I suggest to somebody in here, he can bless you in the house of God. But there are two or three, I want y'all to talk back to the preacher, who are gathered together in my name. How many of y'all know he'll be in the midst? Anybody know God? He'll show up before time. But how many of y'all in here know he'll show up right on time? Anybody ever needed the Lord and the Lord stones? Let me suggest to somebody today, when I'm not forgetting my stones, then guess what happens? I can have the stones, or I can see the stones come alive. Can I suggest today that the stones are not there just to be there, but the stones have been built on the altar for the purpose of worship, that the stones might come alive? Are y'all in here with me? Here it is. When Israel crossed Jordan's River, they again, they arrived at the place of Canaan. That place of Canaan, again, there, they set up great stones there in the place of Canaan, and they would plaster them with plaster so that they can now write on the stone. Are y'all in here with me? The writing on the stone would now be incorporative of the words of the law in which God had first given unto Moses. I want to suggest to somebody in here, the writing on the stone would not to benefit those that came from Egypt over Jordan into Canaan, but can I suggest to you, the writing of the stone would be to those that would soon pass that away. Can I suggest to somebody in here, every Sunday morning we're writing on the stone. Can I tell somebody, every Wednesday night we're writing on the stone? Why? Because you do know somebody is going to come behind us. Do you know somebody is going to pass this way? But can I tell somebody, if I can just leave something behind to let them know to put their trust in God, he'll see him through. Can I tell you, that might be helpful to just one person. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. That's why I'm glad this morning that I can love the fact that my stone can come alive. Why? Because when my stone come alive, it just don't benefit me, but can I tell you, it'll benefit somebody else. Do I have any help in here? When my stones come alive, no, it just don't help me, but let me tell you, it's able to help somebody else. Why? Because when the word of God rings true, whoever will read the word of God upon the stones that have been written upon, can I tell you, their lives can be changed. I wish I had somebody in the building today that will understand that, yeah, because I read the stone, my life has been changed. Is there anybody here, thank God, that when you read the stone, your life has been changed? How many of y'all know you've been born again? Some of y'all looking at me like I'm talking foreign language, but let me tell you, when my life has been changed, I can tell the world whose side I'm really on. When these stones come alive, can I tell you about the stones? When the stones come alive, watch this. The stones now produce inspiration for dedication. Here in Israel, they cross Jordan's River. They're in the land of Canaan. And according to verse 8, the first thing the Lord says, thou shalt write. Here's what I want you to note today. It's inspiring to the belief. fight, that whatever I'm going through, whatever I'm dealing with, the word of God, it'll take care of me. It's inspiring to know that if I dedicate my life to the worship, not of the stones, but upon the altar which represents the worship of my God, how many of y'all know he'll take care of you? Are y'all in here with me? No, you don't worship the stone, but you worship at the altar, the place of the stone. Why? Because you're dedicated to the Almighty God. Can I just drop my kickstand there to tell somebody? That's why I don't need nobody to pump me or prime me. No, I don't need nobody to push me when it comes to my worship. Do I have any help in here? Because when it comes to my worship, I want to display the goodness of the Almighty God. I wish I had somebody in here that would know God has been good to you. How many of y'all know he's been good to you? How many of y'all know he's brought you from a mighty, mighty long way? How many of y'all know that the Lord has done for you what you can't do for yourself? I dare you to give the Lord a praise in this place. Watch this. It produced inspiration for dedication. What did it produce? Inspiration for dedication. McCall told you last week. It was built upon their worship. Let me suggest to somebody in the building, yeah, you ought to be willing to worship God. I want to suggest to somebody in here, you ought to be willing to worship God in spirit and in truth. The writing upon the stones today shared that they were dedicated to leave the word of God behind. They know the fact that the dedication says that they wanted to inspire somebody who would now read the writing upon the stones to know for God I live and for God I die. Can I ask the question, what are you writing on the stone? Can I ask the question, what are you plastering on the stone? Can I ask you a question, what does your stone say? Are y'all in here with me? If your stone is always a stone that talks about how bad you are making it, how bad that you have it, I don't want to read your stone. But when your stone says that you serve a God that's able to make a way out of no way when I'm in trouble, I got to remember God is. Do I have a witness in here? I got to remember God is my all in all. How many of y'all thank God that the God is your all in all? The stones, my brothers and sisters, help produce inspiration for dedication. Why? Because words have been written. Words have been written upon the stone. Are y'all in here with me? I believe today in my imagination that, yeah, the stones have been built. And I believe the words have been written on the stone. I believe had come from the very breath of the Almighty God. Are y'all in here with me? How do you know? Because it uses the word plaster. You know, it was the word plaster that was put upon the stones to make it easier to read. It was the plaster that put it on the stone and made it easier to write. Are y'all in here with me? The materials, my brother and sister, that were used to write upon these stones were materials, I believe, that would again suggest that whatever the stone says, you can learn to believe it. That's why I believe today when we know the fact. Now, what the Lord himself has to say about these stones, then we know the fact that, yeah, we cannot forget our stones. Are y'all in here with me? How do I know? Deuteronomy 27:2 talks about the stones made it easier to make the writing legible. How do I know that? Because whenever I read the word of God, I want to read it so I can understand it. I can't tell nobody about how good God has been to me if I don't understand it. I can't tell nobody how God will bring you out if I don't understand it. I can't tell you how God will make a way out of no way if I don't understand it. Can I ask the question today? Is there anybody in here understand the true, the written, the righteous word of the Almighty God? I'm inspired. I'm inspired for dedication. Do I have a witness in here? That's why my worship has to be for real. Y'all ain't saying nothing to me in the building. I believe my worship has to be for real. Why? Because I can't buy cheap worship. I can't borrow cheap worship. But my worship has to be for real. Are y'all in here with me? That's why when I worship God, I have to put away the gods of the Amorites in whose land that we dwell. but as me in my house, I'm going to worship God. Is there anybody in here? No, you don't worship God. Is there anybody here? No, you got a God you can worship. Is there anybody here? No, if I worship God now, I can live with him then. That's why I praise his name. They produce inspirations for dedication. They that came back will see the writing on the wall. Are y'all in here with me? But what writing, the Bible says, shall they see? And still in verse 8, the text says, thou shalt write upon the stone, here it is, all the words of this law. Do y'all see it? The text says, the words of this law. What am I writing the words of the law for? Because not only do the writing produce inspiration for dedication, not only does the stone produce the inspiration for dedication, but now the stones produce permission for remembrance. Are y'all in here with me? That way, when I see the stone, do I have any, I can be reminded of the goodness of God. And I ask the question today, is there anybody in the building know God is a good God? Anybody in the building know God is a great God? Anybody know he's a God that's worthy of our praise? It's permission for remembrance. Why? Because again, I told you last week, let me say it again, I got to make sure my witness has been seen. But my stone is simply the same stone. It is the stone that the builders rejected. But can I tell you, when my stone came alive, my stone gave a rumbling up under the altar. Can I tell you, with hammer, God raised him from the dead. He got up and put one foot on eternity and one foot on earth. Can I tell you what he said? All power is in my hand. Is there anybody in here that thank God your stone is alive? Is there anybody in here that want to tell the Lord, thank you, sir? Anybody in here got a praise on your heart? Anybody in here that know Jesus hit my stone? I've got to help you. He'll hold my hand. He'll guide my feet. He'll let me know. Everything gonna be alright. Anybody in here gotta praise, you gonna shout now. Anybody in here gotta praise, you can give back. Can you say yeah? Can you say yeah? Can you say yeah? He worthy. He worthy. Hey, hey. He worthy to be praised. Y'all don't hear me now. But can I tell you, if you don't praise him, he got some stones, he got some rocks that are crowded in your place. But can I tell somebody, the third Sunday in July, he's been good to me. He brought me from a mighty long way. Can I tell you what I'm going to do? If don't nobody else say, man, I'm going to tell the Lord, thank you, sir. Have I got any help here? Hey, hey, thank you, sir. There's no need for you to come across the river of Jordan into the land of Canaan. Build an altar for the purpose of worship, and your stone never comes alive. Every now and then, I need my stone to come alive, that my stone can remind me that the Lord is still God, and besides him, there is no other. Do I have just one witness in here? He's still God. Besides him, there is no other. And if you can believe that today, then the Bible says you can be saved. Too many of us are trying to take our stones and build our own altar for our own personal worship. But it's good to to build an altar for your own personal worship, but it's what you write on the wall, on the stone, that leaves a lasting impression. When you leave from your altar is a permanent place, a fixture. When the next person goes by, can they know that you've been with Jesus? If they can't tell you've been with Jesus, then you need to watch what you're writing on your stone. The invitation is extended, the door to God's house is open.
Wow, what a mighty move of God that was. I was electrified. I hope and pray that you were too. First Lady Arnika Day and myself, we would like to say thank you for listening and tuning in to our worship experience this morning.
And we want you to know that we hear you and we thank you for each encouraging word as you faithfully tune in each week to our worship services.
Listen, if you are blessed and would like to be a blessing to this media ministry, you can send any donations of love to P.O. Box 546, Hamilton, Georgia 31811, or simply download the Givelify app and you can search the name Friendship Hamilton.
And remember, as Pastor Day always says, we're not smiling on God,
but God is smiling on us.